in the next few years, human population will be more than 9 billion. Now we have 5 billion people on this planet. So it is necessary to figure out how to feed, how to clothe, how to house this number, huge number of people, and preserve wilderness. The only way how this is possible is to use ingenuity in science and technology. So that's why the Center for Plant Cell Biology is important.
One of the goals we have right now is to produce within the next 25 to 30 years twice as much food for our world. The quest that we really had was, on one hand, to provide farmers with submergence-tolerant rice, but on the other hand, to understand the actual molecular mechanism that provides submergence tolerance. This is a really beautiful example of how we can go from the cell and the gene all the way to the plant breeder and to the farmer. Where are we now? Do we have new varieties of submergence-tolerant rice? And the answer is yes.
Some of the most devastating plant pathogens are fungi. And in terms of human health, there's certain species of fungi that cause infections in humans, particularly immunocompromised patients. The goal of my research is to find or identify proteins that are required for infection or causing disease, and to use these as targets for antifungal agents. So for the first time, we can go into a filamentous fungus and mutate every gene, remove each one at a time. I think the results will be far-reaching, though, to be applied to both plant and animal pathogens.
The tiny RNAs, the small RNAs that we are now studying, they are regulatory molecules. They act in almost all aspects of organisms' physiology, development, and the absence of these small RNAs we call diseases and even deaths. My group's work on small RNA methylation was also found to be universal in multicellular organisms. So once we understand the mechanisms of small RNAs, we could harness the power of small RNAs to treat human diseases.
My lab in particular is looking into both chemical and genetic approaches to improving a plant's ability to grow under with less water. Unless we develop the crops and the farming practices for sustainable agriculture, we're in big trouble longer term, and we already see the consequences of deficiencies in agriculture in developing nations where people go hungry.
That's how it's all interconnected, and that's why it's so exciting, because it's a one chain, we're all in all of this together.